So in 2025, you might want to use Apple Notes. Well, it is a good choice because a lot of people are moving to it. And it's recently got something called Apple Intelligence, which a lot of people are finding an attractive solution to combine AI with their note taking. Today, we're going to show you how that works on the Mac and some of the pre-features that have launched and where it could potentially head in the future. So let's join me over on the desktop and we'll find that. So if you're interested in AI tools in general, you can jump over to our guide for AI tools and download it for free. You'll find it linked below. It is a great way to get caught up on what AI really means and how it's going to affect your productivity. So if you haven't noticed, this is a meeting note that I took. And essentially what we're going to do is show you how to use the AI features. Now the AI features will appear up here as writing tools. And there's a few different things that you can do with them. The first two predominant ones are proofreading it and rewriting it. So I'm going to press the proofread button, and what it's going to do is scan all of the text. And what I actually did is I intentionally created spelling mistakes throughout it. Now, what it's done is it's gone through all of those spelling mistakes. So if I go and revert it, you'll see that there's meeting afternoon spelt wrong, and there's loads of other upcoming spelt wrong and things like that. Essentially what it's done is it's picked up on all of them and changed them automatically. So still going through the text, does this weird like wiping animation. And once it's done, it's found 47 changes and it's going to show you where they all are. So obviously it's picking up on my poor spelling. It's not actually Grammarly or anything. It looks like the underlining logo, but if I press done, then I can basically do that. You can also provide feedback or you can get it to be rewritten. So that's essentially how to do the proofreading, which essentially just cleans up the note. If I go here, I can use a selection of text to rewrite it. And you can see here, it's gonna be rewritten. And there you go. So it's made it a lot more formal, but obviously I haven't given it much prompt. So what it's done here is actually revert back, I believe, or no, I didn't think it did that. But you can go backwards and get them to change it or tweak it. So obviously that's a benefit. So rewriting it doesn't really give it a prompt. It sort of more refines the structure. So here I can change it to be more professional if I want to. I think it's already fairly professional, but you can really do a lot more sort of structural stuff to that. So Carol encountered traffic congestion. and you can really make it sound a lot better. You can also make it more concise, which will condense it into much smaller, despite the tardiness. So obviously it's still very formal. So what I'm gonna do is use the friendly mode. Now what's nice as well is it does this quite well. So here, I can't wait to see you for future projects held. So it keeps it light but airy, if you know what I mean. So one thing you can do is turn things into summaries or key points. So for example, if I select this piece of text, it's gonna allocate, for example, who were the meeting participants, what was the purpose, and what was the meeting time. So here, that's basically taken the weight out of understanding the meeting. If I were to do that with all of it, and use the, turn it into a summary or a list probably more approachable, because it's a really long piece of text. So what it's gonna do is really try and bring that into understandable chunks. It's actually a really long piece of text. So what it's doing, I think it's almost 1,500 words. This is a totally fake one that I've pulled from ChatGPT to mock up for this video. But you can see it's turned everything into a list. I love bullet points, so this is perfect for me. And what it's gonna do is once it's finished, it's a really sort of buggy application, or how it works at least. It still keeps a lot of stuff at the bottom, strangely. But essentially what I can do here is I can reselect it and get it to be summarized. So it obviously gonna give me an option. Here we go. So I can basically turn everything, or at least every section, into a summary. And that's it. That's quite easy to consume. There we go. So I'm constantly breaking this down. And I can also use a table or convert it into a table. So I've instantly turned all of my notes from that entire long document into a table. So meeting highlights and next steps all brought together. So one of the benefits to this might be if you're using audio transcription in a meeting, you could potentially use Apple Notes. So if you're in a meeting and you wanted to record it, then you could potentially just put the actual Apple Notes recording inside of the meeting and then get it to transcribe it and then turn it into this proofreading element. So obviously using it can be a great way across a day to just take advantage of the one. And here is where the meeting notes recording could come in. So that's how you use the transcription. You can also use the new AI summary, which won't show obviously because I'm not recording. But for example, if I was demonstrating this, I could potentially get a summary, and I'm just testing this feature to see and demonstrate how it operates. So obviously it's dictating all of that. And what it's gonna do is provide me a summary. Here, let me show you. Testing a feature to demonstrate how it operates. That's really useful. So obviously you can use this, you can take advantage of it inside of any aspect, but that's just a demonstration of how the new AI note-taking features work on Mac at least. So obviously I think this is rolling out for iOS and obviously Mac, you need to make sure you subscribe to the list to get accessed. But if you're interested in how AI is going to affect productivity, you can follow this channel and discover more. So thanks very much, and I'll talk to you all. So thank you very much, and I'll talk to you all very soon. Cheerio.